I've always told people, I'm not really an instrumentalist, I'm a singer first, but then the medium of that voice just so happens to be the cello.
What was your inspiration behind Renegade?
I just kind of been making music for fun outside of Pentatonix, putting some ideas together. And we got signed to RCA, and they were like, you know, this is some of the most kind of refreshing type of instrumental music we've heard. It's just you have a very different style. And so they thought, you know, that was a really cool, interesting idea where I come to play the cello. So it's just very, very cool to have an album out.
You're a singer, but also multi-instrumentalist. How did you discover those musical talents?
Oh, man. My parents just put me into music lessons, and I just kind of always tried a lot of different things, and certain things stuck.
You also managed to combine the cello world with beatboxing.
It took me a long time to kind of get going. You're doing two very technically difficult things at the same time. So figuring out how to do that, it just lots of time. But, you know, I'm glad it's paid off.
As an instrumentalist myself, I know it's so difficult to talk while you play.
Yes,
I can't
you are
even
not
having,
wrong.
Having like a rhythm with, you know, your voice.
No, for sure. Oh my goodness.
So, like me, you were on From the Top, and how was your experience with that?
I love, love. From the Top. It's such an amazing platform for people to showcase the young talent that we have in the United States and all over the world. When I was on the From the Top, I did a cello performance and I did a saxophone performance. I did beatboxing on From the Top too, which was really interesting. And it gave me the confidence to be a musician. At the time, I wasn't necessarily going to pursue it, but it was kind of some of the initial, I think, underpinnings that made me realize, you know, I could do this. I'll never forget, when I applied for From the Top, I didn't make it. My first time. And so, you know, I was just very, very persistent and I was happy that I could finally do it. It taught me a lot.
How was it transitioning from the Top to being a Grammy award-winning artist?
Oh man, it's always weird to say Grammy-winning artist. It's just cool to know that, you know, all the hard work has paid off. One of the things that From the Top did was give me a basis to which I know, you know, nationally I could perform and not to be nervous about performing. All the things I learned from the Top about giving back, all those things I think manifested itself throughout my career.
Would you give any advice to kids who are hoping to make it big like you did?
You know, obviously practice your craft, but as you're practicing your craft, explore. Because I think that's the one thing that helped me find the voice that I wanted. To make it big, whatever that really means, honestly, just follow your heart and figure out what's unique about you and follow that.
Do you
want to
do like two bars before I come in?
Or? Yeah, arms go one, two,
okay.
Three.